Google's new AI technology is making waves in the tech industry and has everyone wondering, will it outperform OpenAI's ChatGPT? In this video, we will dive into the capabilities of Google's new AI and see if it will be the end of Elon's ChatGPT. We will explore the differences in their abilities and see which one comes out on top. We will take a closer look at the strengths and weaknesses of each technology and evaluate their performance in key areas such as language generation, natural language processing, and decision making. Stay tuned to find out if Google's new AI will change the game in the world of artificial intelligence and which of these three technologies will reign supreme. The race is on, and the two tech giants, Microsoft and Google, are neck and neck in their competition to launch the latest and greatest in AI-related web search tools. Google just made a major announcement and revealed the new chatbot named Bard. Bard is powered by Google's Language Model for Dialogue Applications, LAMDA. LAMDA and engineers have described it as being so human-like in its responses, they believe it to be sentient. Google's new AI is based on a cutting-edge technology called reinforcement learning, which allows it to learn through trial and error. This sets it apart from OpenAI and ChatGPT, which are language models that rely on pre-trained data to generate text. Reinforcement allows Google's AI to make decisions based on the outcomes of its actions, making it a stronger contender in the field of decision-making. It is trained on vast amounts of data from the web to provide users the most compelling responses to their prompts. In just a matter of weeks, Bard will be joining the Google search family, bringing together the vast wealth of knowledge from around the world with the intelligence and imaginative flair of advanced language models. This means you can expect speedy and high-quality responses from Bard, making your online conversations seamless and enjoyable like never before. According to CEO of Google, Sundar Pichai, Bard will combine the breadth of knowledge available on the web with the power, intelligence, and creativity of large language models. The goal is to provide users with fresh, high-quality answers to their questions. Bard aims to be a fierce competitor with the highly popular AI chatbot, ChatGPT, which was released by AI research company OpenAI and already has caused a sensation since its public launch in late November. The Bard is unveiled at a time when Google's core product, online search, is facing its most significant challenge in years. One of the creators of Gmail even went so far as to tweet that Google may be only a year or two away from total disruption due to the rise of artificial intelligence. However, the chatbot hasn't had the smoothest start, with experts pointing out a factual error in its first demo. During a promotional video for Bard, the chatbot gave an incorrect answer to a question about the James Webb Space Telescope. The error was quickly spotted and reported, causing Alphabet's stock to fall by 9% and shaving off $100 billion from its market cap. Google's launch event was overshadowed by reports of Bard's error, and the event itself failed to impress attendees who were expecting something astounding. To make matters worse, Microsoft upstaged Google's launch event by announcing a new version of its search engine, Bing, that was developed with OpenAI, the company behind highly popular ChatGPT. Microsoft has added conversational AI tools to both the Bing search engine and Edge browser. Microsoft worked with OpenAI on ChatGPT, and an upgraded version of that AI technology has been integrated into Bing and Edge. The new OpenAI model used in Bing is faster, more accurate, and more capable, making it more powerful than ChatGPT. Bing with ChatGPT integration is available for a limited preview, and Microsoft plans to scale it to millions of people in the coming weeks. The wrong answer of Google AI highlights one of the biggest challenges with AI chatbots like Bard and ChatGPT. They can confidently state incorrect information as fact. These systems often hallucinate or make up information because they are trained on a huge corpora of text and analyze patterns to determine the next word in a sentence. In the case of ChatGPT, the bot has prompted a wave of admiration for its creative responses to human prompts when it first launched. It has been used for a wide range of purposes, from writing essays and stories to generating song lyrics and answering questions that would previously have been searched for on Google. There have been increasing concerns about its accuracy and ability to provide reliable information. In fact, the errors are frequent enough, between 5 and 10% of the time, to make users increasingly wary of its answers. This problematic approach has led one AI professor to label AI chatbots as bullshit generators. Google has declared launching its own chatbot as a Code Red project and pushed its LA MDA team to prioritize it over other projects. However, the mad rush to beat Microsoft led to the oversight of Bard's mistakes. Now, Google has acknowledged the importance of a thorough testing process. This time, it will be kicking off its Trusted Tester program to ensure Bard's responses meet high standards of quality, safety, and real-world information. When it comes to the demonstrations of Microsoft's new Bing and Google's Bard, both companies have shown different approaches to how they will present the answers provided in their respective chatbots. In Microsoft's demonstration, the chatbot's answers will be displayed on the side of the page and will include footnotes and links to source material, making it appear more trustworthy. On the other hand, Google's example of Bard showed a single summarized answer in the middle of the page with no footnotes or sources, making it difficult for users to identify the source of the information. Microsoft is playing on the safe side by placing liability on the user as ChatGPT does. It comes with a disclaimer that reads, "Bing is powered by AI, so surprises and mistakes are possible. Make sure to check the facts and share feedback so we can learn and improve." However, Google has not shown any warning that their tools could give inaccurate answers. This is a concern, as the technology is still far from being robust enough to be considered reliable. That's according to Ori Goshen, co-founder of A121 Labs, a startup that competes with OpenAI. Now, this is no small feat for either company, as the end goal is nothing short of owning the next era of online search. With that comes a hefty dose of risk and the potential for error. Both companies are relying on AI systems that have been trained on billions of words on the internet. But the problem with this is that these systems can give incorrect or even biased information. Google also runs the risk of incurring the wrath of web publishers who rely on its search page to bring traffic to their sites. The company has had the technology to introduce AI-powered answers to search queries for many years, but has refrained from doing so, as it would disrupt a $150 billion business that hinges on getting people to click around its search results. Now that it's finally taking the leap, the anger from publishers who've accused the company of abusing its dominance may only escalate. Additionally, despite strict filters in place to prevent the bot from making political statements or even hate speech, users have found ways to manipulate ChatGPT into making expletive-laden tirades against its creators. The bot has also mysteriously used pro-Russian rhetoric when answering questions about the killing of civilians in Ukraine. The challenges of making these language models more accurate are significant, and despite the efforts of companies like OpenAI to add more parameters to make them better predictors, the accuracy may still be lacking. It's a problem that both Microsoft and Google will likely face, much like the challenges in self-driving car technology that has been nearly there for over 6 years. The AI chatbot world is rapidly growing, with ChatGPT already having reached 100 million users. And Bard, soon to be released, over 1.1 billion users will have access to these experimental chatbots. It's a grand showdown, and the world will be watching to see who comes out on top. The new chat engine wars have officially begun, and it's shaping up to be a messy and maybe risky journey. While AI chatbots have come a long way, they are far from robust enough to be at the forefront. The technology may be mature, but it's just not there yet. To sum it up, each technology has its own unique strengths and weaknesses. Google's new AI has the potential to revolutionize decision-making, but still has room for improvement in language generation. In conclusion, the great AI chatbot race is underway, and it will be messy and fraught with risk. Both Microsoft and Google are vying for the top spot in the next era of online search, but with the challenges of accuracy and the potential for backlash, the outcome is uncertain. With both companies investing billions of dollars in AI, it's clear that they believe it will bring about a major return. Let's see who comes out on top in the race to revolutionize online search. Click the next video for more on the world's latest in technology.